This is
the best
3D print glue, period.
You need to glue some 3D prints together, and I know the ultimate glue. Let me show you the recipe. Here's the deal. You can use CA glue for 3D prints, and the reality is that it just plain simply sucks. It will break, it's brittle, it never seems to work. I've got a method using some solvents and some of the leftover scraps that you have to make your own glue for PLA prints that is bomb-proof. Now here's the reality. This stuff is toxic. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's gonna melt down the plastic chemically. You want to be somewhere in a well-ventilated area. You're also gonna want to have proper PPE. You want to have a mask on your face with cans on it that are capable of handling chemicals. Gloves, you're gonna wanna have the gloves because you don't want this stuff on your hands.
You would think putting on gloves would be easy for the average person. Not for the unaverage person like myself. This stuff, important, or lots of air.
You're gonna need some of this stuff. It's called Plasti-Strut. It's the stuff that's used to glue styrene together. Melts the plastic and you join the plastic together and it is a chemical weld. What we're gonna do is get little tiny mason jars. Links to everything will be down below if you wanna buy some of this stuff. You're gonna take some of your old 3D prints that have failed, those little bastards that you just, you're gonna take them and you're gonna dice them up into tiny little pieces and then you're gonna throw them in a bath of acid where they're gonna melt.
Okay, it's not acid, it is a solvent. But it feels better to say acid.
Emotional damage!
Grab this guy right here. Get whatever color of filament that you want to use. You can add the filament first or second. I'm using about 12 inches, 16 inches, somewhere in that range. Then we get the Plasti-Strut and we add that. You can use some other solvents like this one here. This is methyl chloride. Again, toxic as hell. You don't want to have this stuff on you or in you. Make sure these things are closed. Give her a little shake. And eventually, it will turn into what the glue is that you see here. We're going to take our nice red glue, give her a little shake. This is the consistency that I like. It's kind of maple syrup, kind of. Also get the other edge. And place that down into the little groove. Let's take the paintbrush and come along and just fill in all those little gaps with the glue.
Bonuses of doing this are white PLA glue, translucent orange PLA glue, red PLA glue. You can make PLA glue in whatever color or whatever filament that you have. You can always make new different colors for anything and you will not see the glue lines because it's the same color. Now for the ultimate trick.
Bonus trick!
Throw as much of the filament that you can into one of these little cans until you get a thick, gloopy mess. And that is the ultimate filler. That will fill in gaps.
I made a really deep seam right along here that I don't necessarily like, and I want to fill it. You can get a little scraper like this. And now you've got filler and do all sorts of neat stuff.
Now that, my friends, is how you can glue stuff together that's PLA, ABS, or PETG by making your own glue. And that glue is amazing. Better than anything you can buy. Hands down. You're welcome. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, blah, blah, blah. Fuck, I don't care. Everybody's telling me I need to say this. Do I need to say this? I don't know. I wish I didn't.